Saigon. Shit. Nothing.
You want to go to a party?
Sure. Where?
Rivik ran into Rebecca O'Malley. She said we should go. You want to go? I'm meeting them in Harvard Square at 9. You want to go?
Sure.
Cool. Okay. See you.
Okay.
I'm gonna go. where it is. Yeah, come on.
I can't think what it is. Are you sure this is the right place?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You're going home tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
You think you could give me a ride?
I thought you were skipping Thanksgiving this year. I thought you had to work.
Yeah, in the afternoon. I just want to go in, you know, home for a few hours.
Sure. That's no problem.
Thanks, Simon.
Yeah, around 7?
Sure, thanks.
Okay. Hey, by the way, check this out.
I got one, too.
Hey, wait, somebody's coming. Man, Harvard students are such assholes.
So, you write poetry?
Yeah, that's right.
About what?
Oh, different things. Homelessness, the environment, ethnic cleansing.
Cool. So, are you glad you dropped out of school?
I don't know.
Well, I took time off. I think you need to. You learn so much. For instance, when I took my year off, I traveled to Costa Rica and I worked for the Undersecretary of Development. And suddenly my education seemed to be part of a plan. I said diplomatic corps. Do you know what I mean?
No.
Well, you know what I mean, though.
Glad Beverly makes jewelry out of rabbit droppings.
What?
What are you doing with your time?
Nothing. I'm working on a mail order.
No, you're finding yourself.
No.
Can I have another cigarette?
Yeah, she raises rabbits and she saves the droppings and covers them in shellac and then makes beads and earrings out of them. Christmas always sucked because she'd give it out as presents, and she wouldn't wrap it. She'd always want to put this shit directly on you and would be like, ah, don't touch me with that, it's shit. I don't want it on my skin.
That's really funny.
Tom, can you give me another gin and tonic, please?
Sure.
So I was doing this internship at NBC.
Did you get that from me?
Fabulous.
Any more of those necklaces? I'd love to have them. It would make a great conversation.
No. Dad would always take them out back and bury them after Aunt Beverly left.
Well, it could have been worse. Your aunt could have raised cows.
Then we would have gotten the paperweights for Christmas.
Nothing. Just a minute! Hey, Murphy.
You leaving?
Yeah, I gotta get up early tomorrow, so.
Oh, work?
No, actually, Simon's giving me a ride home, so.
Well, great. So you're coming to the game. I'm sure everyone will want to see you.
Well, maybe. I mean...
Are you okay? Do you want to talk? I mean, I'm about to leave, too.
No, that's fine. I'm fine. I just kind of want to go be alone.
Okay.
Thanks.
Hey, no problem, man. I will see you at the game.
Okay.
Is that a friend of yours?
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, I should probably get going, too.
Oh, you're going?
Yeah, I gotta go meet my sister. She's giving me a ride home for Thanksgiving.
Where do you live?
About an hour away.
When are you meeting your sister?
Soon.
Oh.
Listen, are you busy with your family tomorrow? Tomorrow night?
Just in the afternoon. Why?
Do you... want to go to a party?
Yeah, I got one too.
Are you gonna go?
I don't know. Are you?
Yeah, probably. I don't think anything else is going on tomorrow night.
Maybe I'll go. Do you know who's having it?
Kurt Swan.
Kurt Swan?
Did you know him?
Yeah. Who else is going?
Hello, boys. We've got something for you.
Dad, it's not going to be.
Is like a practical joke that parents play on their kids.
So, how did you and Tom get together? He doesn't seem like your type.
What's my type?
I don't know, not him.
Well, he's got a good body, you know. He's rich.
Oh, well.
I'm only kidding. I don't know. I didn't really know anybody when I first got here. I wanted a boyfriend, but I'd say it's pretty much over.
Yeah?
Oh, God, that's like... Oh, no, never mind.
No, what?
Oh, no. Well, once Tom and I were... Forget it. It's too embarrassing.
For you or for him?
Well... For him.
Well, then, you and Tom were...
Well...
Conjugating the verb.
Conjugating. And so, right in the middle of it, I start trying to remember where I had left my pink hairbrush, right? Because it had been missing for a few days.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's, you know, going and going, and I'm thinking and thinking. And suddenly, it comes to me. I had left it in my friend's room, right? So I go, oh, right? Like, and Tom starts going, oh, yeah, right? And I look up, and he has this face like, right? And suddenly, the whole thing strikes me so funny that I start laughing hysterically. And well, Tom thinks that he's like giving me multiple orgasms or something, right? And finally, I'm laughing so hard that I think I'm gonna die. So I start screaming, stop, right? But Tom starts screaming, oh no, I can't stop now, oh yeah!
Rebecca? Rebecca? Rebecca?
Rebecca?
Hey, Zeke. How's it going?
Yo, man, can we, like, crash your apartment?
Oh yeah, sure. Of course.
Thanks, man. Oh, this is Regina, man.
Hi.
Kill yourself?
Oh, no. I just,
Oh, thanks, man. Yo, you got like a straw?
Oh, yeah, sure. What happened to your neck?
Oh, we were squatting in this place in Central Square. There was like 10 people. I mean, it was really cool. I mean, everybody was really cool, but we were just sitting around tweaking out, and this bunch of fucking Nazi skinheads show up and start acting like real assholes. So I say to them, yo, man, this is our place. Stop acting like such a bunch of dickheads. So they beat the shit out of me and this other kid to try to help me. It sucked, man. I think I almost choked to death on my tongue.
Wow. That sucks.
If I ever see those guys again, I'm gonna kill them. I know a guy that thinks he can get me an Uzi.
Thanks. Got any pot?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit, is this our Yuba?
Yeah.
I haven't seen this, man. Oh, shit, they put me in!
Let me see.
Oh. Did you get it?
What was it, a deer?
Zuka, you didn't have to kill it.
What, were you gonna nurse it back to health?
No.
You couldn't just leave it there wounded, man. That'd be fucking cruel. You fuck up, don't you watch where you're stepping?
Hey, man, eat me. You just killed Beethoven.
You loser. Come on, man. We don't want to be late for the game.
Becca? You going home? Do you need a ride?
It's okay. Okay.
Okay.
Simon's giving me a ride back home later if you want to.
Oh, no, man, that's cool. Thanks.
Okay.
Murphy, I think I'm in trouble.
What's that?
I think I had sex with Simon last night.
You think?
I don't know. I know something happened. I'm just not sure exactly what. I know I was naked when I woke up this morning. And I think that he was too.
Well, you like him, right?
Well, sure, but I don't know. Is he still like how he was, you know, in high school?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean.
Well, Simon is very consistent. He's always been very idealistic. Are you coming? Someone would save him from that dead end job. He won't go anywhere if he just sits there wishing. Oh, Christ, you sound just like my mother.
Murphy!
Murphy,
when did you get that?
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Oh, hi, Simon.
Oh, hi.
Wagner, you've graduated. Leave the jailbait alone.
Hey, man, how you doing? Look at you.
Hey, Zuka.
Simon, happy Turkey Day. How are you?
Nice do.
Thanks. You should think about getting one.
No, that's okay. No.
Perry, I haven't seen you in years. How you doing?
I'm fabulous. How have you been doing?
Not too bad, not bad. You fucked up your hair. I guess it doesn't look too bad.
Zuka, I want you to meet my roommate, Mike. He didn't have a place to stay, so my family's taking him in for the holiday.
It's nice to meet you.
Hey.
Hello, darling.
Hey, Heidi.
Hello, Zuka.
Heidi, hey.
Hi, you must be cold.
I'm used to it. You look good.
Thank you, dear. Isn't this wonderful? Everybody's back this year.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, Simon.
Oh, hi.
It's wonderful to see you. Is Zeke home, too?
Yeah, he's around somewhere.
Hey, Zeke, how's it going?
Oh.
Hey, Max, how are you?
Okay.
Yeah.
How's college?
Oh, I'm not. I dropped out.
Yeah?
Yeah, I really hated it. And I've got this job that like a trained chimp could do. It's really stupid. I don't know what I'm doing there. It's like, I'm just really getting bored, you know? I'm just thinking, I just really want to just get away, you know? I mean, I'm thinking of going, I don't know, I was like, maybe, I was thinking of going, maybe go to Nevada, you know? Or just like someplace with mesas. Because I just had this craving lately to see geographical formations that I haven't seen before.
Yeah, that's cool.
Well, how are you? What are you up to these days?
Just hanging around, you know?
Yeah. And what are you doing?
I'm working at Rich's, doing inventory, shit like that.
Yeah, that's cool.
And I'm working weekends at Tremont's, the liquor store in the Rotary.
Oh, yeah, that must be convenient.
It's okay, I guess. I don't know, just making money, hanging around, you know?
So, you still going out with Heidi?
Yeah.
So, Murphy, you going to the party tonight?
Which party?
The one Kurt Swan's having. You must have heard about it.
Yeah, I got an invitation. How do you know it's from Kurt?
Who else could it be? He must be out of prison.
He was in prison?
Last I heard.
For what?
Manslaughter? I don't remember. Max told me.
Hey, Rebecca!
Oh, hi, Simon.
When did you get here?
I came with Murphy. Picked me up at the tea station.
Oh. You know, I asked you if you needed a ride this morning.
Yeah, I know. I needed to sleep.
Oh. I mean, you know, I would have come in and picked you up at the tea station.
It's okay. Murphy had already agreed to do it. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Who's winning, anyway?
Oh, I don't know. Here.
Oh. Simon, that's sweet. Thank you. Listen, I'm gonna go over and say hi to Perry, okay? I'll be right back.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Hey, Zuka.
Hey, how come you haven't called me, asshole?
Sorry, I've been working a lot lately.
Yeah. I mean, I don't see what's so great about peace. Everything just gets sloppy. It's not like people don't get killed during peacetime, right? I mean, people kill each other. It's natural. Most people can barely stand their fucking friends, let alone all the fucking strangers dicking them over every day. You need wars or it'll all just get out of hand. What pisses me off is how short the wars are now. They never settle anything. That's what I want. Get all those little bullshit countries that are always giving us shit, have them team up and just come at us. And we could just go at it, man, once and for all. One last big one. One last good one. That would be intense.
And then what? You'd be out of a job.
No way, man. I'd never be out of a job. What the fuck is wrong with you? You could have went in with me, Greeny, and Elvis.
I really don't see myself as a Marine.
What are you, some kind of pussy? No, I'm serious, man. I'm serious. You know, it's cool if you want to hang around here. I know you're into Heidi and everything, but you should really think about it. I hate to say it, but it probably beats the piss out of working at Rich's.
You're probably right.
So what's the deal with you and Heidi, anyway?
I don't know. Used to be really great, but she's just a bitch all the time now, you know? It's never any good. We're not even fucking friends.
So fuck her.
Yeah, I know, but Heidi and me broke up once before, and you know, I get up in the morning, I go to work, I come home, watch TV, jerk off, go to bed. Over and over again. Every day. For months. I don't know, man. Everybody's gone. The only people I ever see are people at work, and they're all dicks. My family's fucked up. Nothing ever happens. At least with Heidi. I don't know. At least I have someone to hate.
I like you, Max, but Jesus, you are one sorry pussy-whipped bastard. Look, a bunch of people will be coming over to my house this afternoon. You should come over and get shit-faced with us.
I can't. I have to go to Heidi's.
I'm hungry.
Have some turkey.
Oh, yeah. Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, God, that is fucking gross.
It's not bad. Want some?
Get that fucking away from me. That is fucking gross, man. You're a fucking pig. Get away from me, man. Fucking disgusting.
Hey, want to go to this?
What is that?
I don't know, it's a party or something.
Vietnam too, holy shit!
What?
I almost died at the first one.
The first what?
Vietnam. It was the summer after I dropped out of high school. Yeah, it was at this guy called Kurt Swans. Way out in the woods, man, way out in the fucking boondocks. Man, he was fucking evil.
Was he an asshole?
No, he was just fucking evil. I don't know what it was. He was just a scary-looking motherfucker. He looked like Satan or something. He was the first person I ever tripped with. Wait, Zeke was there too, yeah, the guy who lives here? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was me, Zeke, and Satan way out in the woods in this cabin. Tweaked out of our minds. And this guy just kept staring at us with his evil fucking eyes. Freaked the fuck out of Zeke. Remember, he had to leave. So then it was just me and Satan. And he pulls out this old .38 that he must have stolen from his grandfather or something. He puts a bullet in and he spins the chamber. And he keeps spinning it and spinning it. Then he puts it up to his head and he pulls the trigger. So nothing happens. And then he starts staring at me. And he spins it and he spins it. And I just keep watching him like I'm a rabbit in the middle of the fucking road waiting for a car to hit me. So then he puts the barrel up to my head and he pulls the trigger.
And pow! He blew your brains out and you died.
No, he was just fucking with me. There wasn't a firing pin or anything.
Uh-huh.
He's still fucked up, though. I heard he's going around the country selling heroin or some shit with this voodoo cult or Satan worshippers or something. I don't even want to think about how fucked up and evil he must be now, you know?
So, you want to go?
Fuck yeah.
No. Now these are all wrong. These are all going to have to be done over again.
What is it?
We're trying to maintain an semblance of neatness and professionalism. The two hemispheres of the sticker must match like so. You see? Now you. There, you see? Have you got it?
I've got it.
Hey, Zeke, how's it going?
Okay.
And how was your Thanksgiving, huh?
It was okay.
Well, how about that?
Zeke, listen, I want you to know that we've been nothing but happy with your work here, and we have no animosity toward you whatsoever.
That's good.
That's just this damned economy. But if you ever need a reference, I'll have nothing but praise.
A reference for what?
Another job.
Another job? Are you firing me?
Oh, yes. Didn't I say that? Yes, I'm sorry. We've had to lay some people off. You're being laid off, not fired.
I'm fired? I can't come here anymore? I never have to see any of you ever again?
Well...
That cage making men happens down at the Red Room Chinese Lounge. Mickey orders a double with his roast beef stallerange. Whoever meets city beatniks are all late for rehearsal. Stopped off for microsurgical vasectomy reversal. So let's have a party in my welfare hotel. Our own private rendezvous, our little slice of hell. I never meant to hurt you, I'm sorry about the pain. Let's just forget about it, it's time to twist again. Shake it in the rec room, shake it on the deck, shake your little bottom, shake your little neck, yeah. Jack lost 20 large today at the track with Uncle Buddy. You know he owes a bundle to Banana Nose McGillicuddy. Jimmy screwed the preacher's girl down behind the rectory. She said he was a pig, he threw her panties in a tree. So let's get it on down at the Roosevelt Hotel. Ain't nothing on TV tonight, it's probably just as well. You never meant to hurt me, that's just the way it goes. You're acting so sincere, but I know that it's just a pose.
What do you think?
This is the place.
Look, that's Tom's car. Shit, what's he doing here?
This is the place.
I don't hear any music.
Well, maybe it hasn't started yet. You want to go somewhere and come back later?
Go where? There's nothing here.
Look, let's just go in and, I don't know, if we're early, we can go do something else.
What about Tom?
I don't know. If he's here, I'm going to have to talk to him sooner or later.
So, we go in?
Okay.
Sounds good. What's that smell?
I don't know. It smells like something's burning. Well then, guys, maybe we should come back later, huh?
Wait a minute.
Karate to attack, you're a fucking disgrace!
He peed on me!
What?
This big guy just came over and peed on me.
Oh, you were sitting there?
Yes. And he came over and he peed on me, and then he just walked away.
Where did he go?
I don't know. I got peed on.
Oh, of course. Do you live nearby?
So then, I went to visit Angela. We had some scotch. She's from Pakistan. She does these tarot palm card readings. She's teaching me. I could do that. Then what? Oh, the Rev came by. We went down to that park under the bridge, got baked. You know the one? Oh. So then, I went to the pizza pad, split a pitcher of beer with Dave T. Man, this was a wasted day. What the fuck? It's a holiday, right? So I went to the Rat, and there was this wretched band from Cleveland. And all of their songs had titles like Entropy and Infinity. And they did these half-hour instrumentals. Of course, I couldn't stand it anymore, so I went outside, and I couldn't find anywhere to sit, so I sat on the curb. And then I got peed on. Ta-da! Hey, what's your name?
Zeke.
I'm Felicia.
I know. I've seen you sing. You're great.
Oh, thanks. You're cute.
Oh, thanks.
You know, we're the first generation of kids raised on Sesame Street.
Well, that explains a lot.
Ah! I still got pee on me. Hang on, I'll be right back. Oh, do you want something to drink?
Yeah.
Or something? Okay. Oh.
Thanks for bringing me home, Zeke.
Oh. Well, I'm glad I did.
Yeah, me too. I'll be right back.
Sorry.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Mickey.
Oh, are you Felicia's roommate?
No. I really don't know who anyone here is. Do you know where the bathroom might be?
No?
Shit. I guess I'm gonna go out and have to find the bush pretty soon. Nice meeting you.
Excuse me. Here. Are you tripping?
No, Murphy, look.
Am I, you know, crazy? I mean, is there something no one is telling me?
What?
There's something going on.
What's going on? We're at a party.
I don't know how I got here. I followed this girl into her apartment.
Whoa. Who's the girl?
I don't know. I followed her to her bedroom. And then I just wound up here. Where the fuck are we anyway?
Houston or Brookline or something? Look, Zeke, try to relax. Nothing's happening that you won't be able to figure out in the morning. You should come back to the party. You'd be with your friends. You've been isolating yourself way too much lately.
You don't understand. Things are getting weird. I mean, not just tonight. Haven't you noticed? I mean, I'm starting to feel like... I don't know, I'm just starting to wonder who I can trust.
What do you mean? You trust me, don't you, Zeke?
Yeah.
And Simon, and Perry, and Rebecca, and Zuka, and everybody likes you, Zeke.
I guess you're right.
So why don't you come back in? Maybe you can find that girl again.
I'll go in a minute. I'm just gonna have a cigarette.
You okay, man?
Fine. Thanks, Murphy.
All right.
Cortez Street. I stayed with a guy on Cortez Street once. It's right around here.
You've been saying that for the past hour. Why don't you just ask somebody?
All right. Jesus Christ, stop fucking whining.
Fuck you.
I'll ask, okay?
Good. Fucking guys, you're all the fucking same. Never want to stop
Shut
and
up.
Fucking ask for directions.
Shut up.
You've got to find
what am I
it
doing?
On your own.
I'm asking, all right? Hey, man.
Ah. Jesus.
What the fuck?
Puke.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Watch out! You almost hit them.
No, I didn't.
What's wrong with you tonight?
Nothing.
Love you, man.
I love you too, man. Kurt.
So
So are we going in?
Hold it. I just want to sit here for a minute.
I'm going in. So you're just gonna sit in the car?
Yeah.
Fine. You're being an asshole. I'm going inside.
In the bathroom yet?
Yes, finally. Have you been upstairs yet?
No. Wow!
Say it. I look like a lesbian dominant.
You look great. Where's Max?
I don't know. He wanted to stay in the car.
So what were you saying now? Your dark, dystopic future?
No, I was just saying how fucked up everything is now. Now the people in charge, the ones who fucked it up in the first place, finally realized that they'd be screwed too if they didn't do something. So they made it cool to be into the environment and everything after they'd already had all the fun. So I figure what you're going to see in about 20 years is all the businesses and religions and things like that, after centuries of being manipulated to work against each other, will finally be manipulated into cooperating to come up with a solution.
Which will be what?
Giant spaceships.
This is Mickey. She's a friend of Rebecca's from Harvard.
Mm. Hi.
This is Heidi. She was a friend of mine from high school.
Mm-hmm. Oh, did you graduate together?
No. Murphy graduated when I was just a little freshman.
Oh, so you're still in high school.
Now, the spaceships would be continuing the human race and exploring the galaxy. I mean, you could walk in space, but you'd never see the Earth again or experience nature, and you'd probably die before you got to a habitable planet. And here's the thing to remember. In the ships, it would be the ultimate closed society. I mean, the government would have complete control.
Guy, get the fuck out.
It's Perry Lutton, that little faggot from homeroom senior year.
I got a boner looking at him, man. I'm gonna fuck him up.
At all.
stay behind on the dying planet, you know, a world with no future, no resources, but there'd be so few people left that you could do anything you wanted. Of course, the people who'd be left would mostly be criminals and cast-offs, because the government didn't want in the spaceships. So, you'd probably have your warrior tribes and your chieftains and, what's going on?
Talking to Murphy.
Fucking Wagner, man. If I were you, I would fuck him up.
No, it's not his fault.
Keg's empty, man. It ain't even midnight. This party has crotch rot.
Hey, I'm not a bimbo. I'm not saying you are, dear. It's just that you're a little obvious. I mean, it seems like all you want to do is get down his pants. Well, I do.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Look, man, I didn't stop that, but if a bro's involved, I'm involved.
You're sad.
We all can't be so civilized. Some of us can't afford to go to Harvard.
Oh, please. Do you know the bathroom is?
Yeah, it's upstairs. I'll show you.
You don't have to.
Unless you and Murphy are...
Not at all. Not the way, for all I care. I'm just saying it's better if you don't rush. It's better if you give them a little bit and a little bit. Drag it out over months. Build it slowly. Torture them. Torture yourself. Until you squirm every time you see each other.
You're weird.
Not at all. Once you have sex, it gets boring. But my way? Take Max. He has been waiting for 2 years.
You haven't had sex in 2 years?
The poor boy is in a state of continuous sexual excitement now. I mean, he's so horny, he comes in his pants if I even whisper, blowjob, in his ear. When we finally consummate, it will be volcanic. Mm-hmm.
Why don't you just cool it, okay? Hey, I'm going on a packy run. You guys need anything?
Yeah, hold on. I'll go with you, man.
Thanks, I think I can take it from here.
Oh, I have to use it next. Store.
Can I come?
Do whatever you want.
all yours. Simon. I don't think we should be doing this right now.
Why not?
I just got away from Tom. I wonder what happened to him anyway.
Oh, come on. I'm not like Tom.
I know. I meant, I just don't feel like being anyone's girlfriend for a while.
So you're giving up sex?
Well, no.
Okay, we don't have to go out. We can just stay friends.
Right.
But we can still...
No.
Why not?
Because I like you, Simon, and it seems like you really care about me.
Well, I do. I mean... You've always been one of my favorite people. I forgot what a blast it was to hang out with you. I think it's great we ran into each other again.
I know, but...
But what?
But I'm graduating in a few months.
So? So am I.
And I don't have the slightest idea of what I'm going to do with my life, Simon. I mean, I have no idea. I can't even think about it. I want to put up dealing with it while I still can and just enjoy myself.
So why can't we just...
Simon, I just couldn't fool around with you, you know? You'd expect it to go on and become this great love affair. I don't know, it would mean something. It would affect my future. I'd have to deal with it, do you understand?
So, the problem is that I won't just use you for sex and toss you aside?
Oh, sort of, I guess.
Sure I will!
No, Simon!
I promise I won't respect you in the morning.
No, Simon. You know, I don't know, maybe someday things will be different. And we'll run into each other again, but right now, I think we should just be friends, okay? I'm sorry.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Elvis.
Presley.
Birnbaum.
Elvis Birnbaum?
Elvis Presley Birnbaum. I'm named after my father. You know, King.
I'm worried about Tom.
Why?
Well, have you seen him?
Nope. Have you?
No. Why did he just leave his car here?
I don't know. Maybe he met somebody.
Tom? I doubt it. Where'd you get that thing?
I don't know. Back there somewhere?
Sometime the King would have his friends go into town and wrestle up a couple young fillies for him. King just loved watching these teenage girls strip down to their underwear and hit each other with soft, fluffy pillows.
Anyway, I never should have let Simon do whatever it was that we did.
Maybe you didn't do anything.
Oh, no, we did something. Whatever it was, he took it very seriously, and now he hates me.
I'm sure he doesn't hate you.
He seemed pretty upset.
What did you say to him?
I don't know. It didn't make any sense.
So, what happened after the pillow fight?
Hey, darling. How'd you like to come over and watch a little Dobie Gillis with me?
These women didn't know was that Dobie Gillis was quite an aphrodisiac. So, everybody else went home and they stayed and watched Dobie Gillis. And one thing led to another.
I don't know. Maybe I'll just become a housewife, you know? Marry some rich jerk and become this fat, spoiled... Hey, where are we anyway? Is this a cemetery?
Yeah?
Terrific.
Anyway, I don't think you need to worry. We're young. We can do anything we want.
Yeah? What do you want to do? Here? You're sick.
We got screwed. When we were being raised, there was still hope. They show you just enough to get you interested, then they take it all away. Fucking baby boomers. fucking baby boomers. We're gonna be behind those assholes the rest of our lives, eating their shit, and there's not anything we can do about it. I wish they would all just fucking die. The fucking 60s, I'm sick of hearing about it. Who gives a shit? The early 80s were great, but do you ever hear about that? No.
You know, we're the first generation of kids to be raised on Sesame Street.
Exactly. Murphy's an asshole. You know, this just isn't any fun anymore. And next year, it'll be even less fun. I mean, we'll all probably be unemployed. Assholes will have all the good jobs, and we'll still get fucking student loan bills every month. I mean, what's the point? Evil fucks always have and always will rule the world, and there's nothing we can do about it. All the good stuff's already been done. We just have to sit around and take it for another 60 years, and then we just die anyway? I mean, who came up with this? You know, I'm 22 years old, and I already feel like I've been alive forever, you know? Sometimes I just think, what's the point? I mean, what am I waiting for? Have you ever thought about that, Zeke? I mean, you know, have you ever thought about just killing yourself?
And Heidi.
Zuka, what are you talking about? Who got Max and Heidi? Who are they?
They all are.
Broken so only to remind me.
hit.
You made it, man.
You look good.
Thanks.
How have you been?
Good. You?
Oh, you know.
Yeah. Same old, same old.
Right. this is a good party.
Thanks.
Did you want to talk to me about something?
Yeah, I think you might want to sit down.
You're a guy.
No, you be the guy.
Going insane, am I? I mean, have you noticed something strange going on here tonight?
You're not going insane.
You have to do it that way.
Hey, man. Sorry I didn't catch up with you sooner. There's not much time left now, I'm afraid. But you know how it is. I'm trying to keep this kind of low key.
Kurt, I think I'm going to start screaming in a moment.
Come on. We'll have a beer and I'll explain everything.
Zeke?
We're at the end of reality, Zeke. We've used it all up, and we've outlived our usefulness. God is tired. There was a riddle we were meant to answer. All we got were bits and pieces. Now we're out of time. And we're just waiting for the end up here.
But where are we? And how did I get here? And why me?
Those were the questions. All I can say is that reality gets pretty frayed near the end. But don't worry, you're safe here.
But what about everybody else?
They won't suffer long.
Where's everybody?
I don't know. Listen, I'm scared. I want to get out of here.
Max? What happened?
Here's the beer. Change.
leave, I'm afraid you can't come back. It's not enough time.
I want to find Felicia.
Okay. It's good to see you again, see?
You too. How much longer do we have?
Not long.
And then we all die?
It's okay. We're together, so, okay? It's gonna be okay. I love you. Okay? We're gonna be okay.
Glad you're with me.
Me too. Okay. Okay, we're gonna figure this out. We're gonna figure this out. Okay?
Crowded room, you catch my eye and I feel that you're wanting to be with me soon. It never gets better. Our love could walk to forever and back.
When I was only 17, I had a vision.
most full of shit self-fitted trip I ever had. I was playing with myself behind the tool shed when I saw Jesus and he told me I was bad. And I said, Lord, did you create me to forsake me? I don't think I've been given my fair chance. I've been tormented and tortured from the get-go. Can you blame me that I do the devil's dance? And he said, when you get to hell, and I'm confident you will, you'd best resign yourself to sit and rot there and look back on the wickedness that typified your life, and you won't have to wonder how you got there. And I cried, name it, I've been tempted by it, whores, barbiturates, and shit, madness, apathy, and suicide. With all your vain attempts to heal me, I beseech thee, is it really such a wonder I've nothing left inside?
Yesterday, but some- something happened along the way. What could it be? Won't you talk to me? Cause that night was not that long ago. Maybe I should fix my watch. Abandoned ship, all hands below. Hey, buddy, can you spare a match? At the telephone, I'm dropping a dime.